Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Automatic Writing Experience, AWE. How to turn your journaling into channeling to get unstuck, find direction, and live your greatest life. By Michael Sandler. Narrated by Michael Sandler.
Special message from Dr. Ervin Laszlo. To something that is entirely true and entirely fundamental. We can contact and communicate with the world. This means we can connect or reconnect to what I've been calling the source. We've known this. All serious, insightful people have known it. But one of the important tools for connecting was missing from our set of instruments, the AWE. I now ask myself, did I have the AWE? Automatic writing experience. Did I actually do automatic writing? At first sight, this sounds unlikely. I and nobody and nothing else wrote what I wrote. But on second thought, I'm not so sure. Not so sure that I alone have written what I've written. Let me tell you my experience. I've not written anything by hand for the past 30 years at least. Too slow for me. I used to be a concert pianist, so my fingers are nimble and I type fast on a keyboard. Almost, but not quite as fast as I think. Now the computer saves it for me. I first write the way it comes, and then I read and reread and revise until I'm satisfied. But what emerges first is not something I worked out beforehand. I know the context and the issue, of course, and I focus on it, but then I let go and write. Doing this is like a physical urge. If I can't put my hand on a keyboard right away, I almost feel sick. I can't think of anything else, and certainly can't do most anything else. Relaxation and sleep are out of the question. When I sit down and write, the sentences form by themselves. I just have to write them down. Is this automatic writing? Is this channeling? Is it a form of inspiration? Is it communing with a superhuman or at least a non-human intelligence? To me, this experience is a deep source of awe and wonder. I'm not alone in writing what I do. I have help. A dictation of sorts, but by no means a random one. It is highly focused on the questions I address, but it flows. And, I should add, it can also block. It doesn't always flow, and the way it's blocked is something quite amazing. Email fails to go through, paragraphs I've written disappear from the file, and on occasion, an entire file becomes inaccessible. Where it goes, I don't know, but why it goes, I can guess. Because in thinking again about what I've written or tried to write, I realize that it's off the mark. I've taken a wrong turn, introduced a wrong hypothesis, or misphrased something I want to convey. In retrospect, I can say, thank goodness it disappeared. Then there is the positive case. When I read and consider what I've written, and it checks with what I see as the relevant evidence, other people's experiences, or a theory or affirmation coming from science, then I'm amazed and elated. So good to know that I'm not at the mercy of my own devices when I expose an idea or a theory, that there is something or someone who works with me, supervises me, and prevents me from making at least major blunders. Thank you, dear Michael, for prompting me to think about this experience. I've never written it down, although I share it with my wife quite often. Every time I'm amazed and either dismayed or elated. Now I can get further feedback from you and your readers, from people who share a keen and hopefully unbiased interest in the phenomenon of AWE and feel the AWE it inspires themselves. From Dr. Ervin Laszlo, two-time Nobel Peace Prize nominee and winner of the Goy Peace Prize, the International Mandir of Peace Prize, the Conakry's Holistic Culture Prize, and the Polyhistor Prize of the Environmental Protection. Foreword. Hello, happy readers. Want to enjoy more peace of mind? Read and do this book. I first met Michael in January of 2020 as an invited guest on his podcast, Inspire Nation, where we discussed my new book, The Healthy Brain Book. Even virtually, Michael radiated vibes, some inner force from his mind into my mind that brought me peace just by watching and listening to his body language. His podcast jumped to the top of my must-see list. In AWE, Michael and Jessica reflect similar vibes as they do in their podcast. You, the reader, will feel a cerebral connection with these two trusted authors as the words from their hearts and minds leave you feeling, this is just what I need. This is just how I want to feel. Their term, AWE, automatic writing experience, belongs in the mental wellness toolbox of every reader who is inspired to take charge of their brain health. I was literally in awe at the end of reading sections that left me feeling, that makes sense. AWE takes you inside your brain while writing. You will be in awe to learn how putting your pen to paper relaxes your brain better than do fingers to keyboard. When you're in the mood to write, your brain particularly loves poetry. One day while writing on the beach, this poem naturally overtook my mind. The loveliness of the land, the softness of the sand, the serenity of the sea, God gave this to me. I remember my favorite spiritual director, Mom, giving me her advice for boredom and upsetting behavior. Go outside and play. AWE inspires, go outside and write. Creative writing also inspires deeper connections with your loved ones by helping you write what you feel. One day as I was writing, Martha walked by and another poem naturally came to me. I feel that I shall never see a lady as lovely as you are to me. AWE is the antidote to ants was my top take-home point while reading this book. Ants, automatic negative thoughts, clutter the minds of so many persons now living in the world of fake news and fear factors. At no time in history has the need for mental wellness tools been so necessary, and why this book is so timely. Michael's story about his ADHD reminds me of when Martha and I were on Good Morning America discussing our ADD book. Joan London asked Martha, "Where did you get the material for your book?" Martha promptly replied, "It's my husband's autobiography." As you'll read in Michael's testimony, ADD is a difference, not a disorder. Some very highly creative and highly sensitive brains are wired differently. We don't try to change these unique brains. Instead, we channel them into the path God created them to have. AWE helps you stay on the path toward your personal peace recipe. Each day in my medical practice, I advise troubled junior and senior minds, find your happy path and carry your personal toolbox to stay on it. Of course, AWE minds are unique, so our mental wellness tools in this book may not fit the spiritual path of everyone. Yet without worry or judgment, take the tools that keep you on your personal spiritual path. Readers, you'll be in awe about the section on meditation and the attitude of gratitude. No matter how much life sucks, and in these troubled times it does, we all have a few things to be thankful for. I begin most mornings with what I call my movement meditation. I move my body, walking or swimming, in rhythm with my mantra, such as, thank you, God, for my life, 80 years. Thank you, God, for my wife, 54 years. Thank you, God, for my health, cancer survivor. Thank you, God, for my wealth, 8 kids. Thank you, God, for my MD. Please make it my ministry. AWE, my mind is in AWE. Thank you, sincere Sandlers, for giving readers and followers a toolbox for happier and healthier living. From William Sears, MD, co-author of the Healthy Brain Book and All Ages Guide to a Calmer, Happier, Sharper You. Introduction. Before I started practicing AWE, the automatic writing experience, I was lost, confused, literally in pain, and wiped out financially and emotionally. Fortunately, I turned to AWE and I heard I was to start a podcast, the Inspire Nation Show, and to interview the best experts from around the world. Now my wife, Jessica, and I are living our dreams with our miracle rescue animals, including a rooster. Yes, a rooster. And our show is one of the top spiritual self-help shows in the world with millions of views and listens. It all came out of automatic writing. All the goodness, all of the magic, all of the miracles, and the same can happen for you. What you hold in your hands now, or hear in your ears, or electronically on the screen before you is a true miracle. It's a system that anyone can follow and will allow you to tap into your inner wisdom or the divine. Not sure where to turn? AWE can help. Health on the rocks? AWE can help. Freaked out by a pandemic, civil unrest, or the latest nightmare? AWE can help too. And certainly if you're struggling to manifest, to get back on your feet, or want to take your wealth and finances to a new level, then Awe is for you. For Awe is a rocket ship when it comes to manifestation. And if you're struggling, stressed out, worried, anxious, depressed, or worse, then Awe will give you not just solace, but can help you heal your mind, help transform the swirling energies inside and outside of you, rewire your subconscious, and help you transform your wounds into powerful, positive energy for positive change, even greater than you could ever imagine. Automatic writing is a tool that's been used in psychology to rewire the subconscious by the likes of Jung and Freud for well over 150 years. The technique may have been a bit lost to modern psychologists, but it's on its way back. More on this in the history section. In December 2019, I interviewed a brilliant astrologer, Dr. Michael Lennox. And together, well before COVID-19, we called 2020 the year of reckoning, meaning everything that we've swept under the carpet or didn't want to deal with would have to be faced. Boy, was that true. But now, I call this time period moving forward the era of reinvention. It's a time of tremendous possibilities. Yes, there's swirling energy all around us. Yes, it seems like Armageddon or worse. But nothing could be further from the truth. When you learn how to plug in, to connect with the universe, connect with your wisdom, or connect with your guides, you'll learn how special this time is, why your soul chose to incarnate during this time, how special you are, and what you're capable of doing, and where to go from here. This time period is like a springboard for powerful, positive possibilities, not gloom and doom. Not even close, but a time of complete and total reinvention where almost anything you dream of is possible. Mind is creator. This is the basic tenet of the entire New Thought movement. Or as you've heard from the likes of Bob Proctor and Rhonda Byrne from The Secret, what we think about, we bring about. What they call the law of attraction. Whatever we think about, focus on, and speak or write about, we can literally draw into existence. Of course, this means be careful what you wish for, but it also means you are the most incredible creator in the world. You need to learn how to harness that energy, and in your hands is the tool. Awe can show you how to change your life, how to up-level everything, how to move past wounds and emotional blocks, and how to call yourself toward the most incredible, outrageous, over-the-top, magnificent future that's so far beyond your wildest dreams, but is already waiting for you. In this book, truly a manual for connecting with the divine for guidance, manifestation, healing, and especially rewiring your subconscious, or for the atheists out there, for connecting with your inner wisdom, you'll be guided step by step on how to tap in, get guidance, and discover the magical world that's already present in the here and now. While I'm an angels guy and an alchemist, you don't have to believe in anything to get magic out of this book. But follow the directions and you'll blow yourself away. For whether we call them angels, guides, light workers, or simply your inner wisdom, or even the quantum field of intelligent energy, there is a deep and profound wisdom just waiting to guide you if only you would ask. As the energies are swirling all around us, as COVID-19 leaves its mark, I have just one question to ask. If not now, then when? If you're not willing to make great change now, if you're not willing to dive into your soul, if you're not willing to take the leap of faith and seek out a different way, if not now, then when? For this tool called Awe is pure magic. It will connect you with the other side. It'll help you find your purpose, your path, your unique direction, and answer life's deepest questions for you. Like, why did I incarnate during this time? Why did I choose this life? Why did I choose these struggles? And how in the world can I turn all of this around me into the greatest positive? How can I transform my life so that I'm truly rocking it on purpose, on path, and doing exactly what I'm supposed to do? And how can I feel happy, especially now? Let's see. Chapter 1. Welcome to the awe-inspired world of automatic writing. I awaken quietly at 4:30 a.m. The world is silent. Even the hummingbirds haven't risen yet. I run through some gratitudes in my head as Jessica sleeps silently beside me. From there, I move stealthily down the stairs to the bathroom, grab a cup of hot water and minerals, take my vitamins, then it's on to the studio. Within my studio sanctuary, I go quiet, meditate, and then put on my headphones and some peaceful theta brain entrainment music. The sound of birds chirping at the beach can be heard between my ears. I go to my Google Drive, open a new automatic writing document. I used to use pen and paper, but the words come so fast I can't keep up. I lean back in my chair. It's still nearly pitch black outside, with just a tiny hint of purple above the horizon. As my eyes slink closed, I write out my first prayer, then another welcoming in assistance, angels and guides, and especially loved ones who've crossed over to the other side. As my prayers finish, the words begin to flow. My fingers take on a life of their own as profound wisdom spills out onto the page. I know it's not for me, as I'm still half asleep. But paragraph after paragraph spill out, one faster than the next. Occasionally, I'll interject and ask a question. But most often, I simply bear witness to the guidance coming from beyond. Hello, bright and shiny beacons of light. This description of my process for automatic writing reflects its simple ritual and beauty. Please allow me to show you how to tap into this inner wisdom and discover your greatest guidance through this ancient art. Imagine being able to talk to a higher power, whatever you wish to call this force or belief, to communicate your every wish, thought, query, and desire to hear an answer clear as day. How would this change your life? When you sit down and initiate your ritual for automatic writing and put pen to paper, this is exactly what happens. Whether you believe in a God, source, universe, or simply your guiding inner wisdom, you briefly meditate, go into prayer, and then your pen begins to write almost without thought. Sound too good to be true? One of my coaching clients, Mary H., told me, quote, "Automatic writing has become a real life-changing experience for me that has become a part of my daily routine most days. The process sets me free from unforgiveness that I didn't realize I had toward my late mom and myself. Through writing and my coaching, the groundedness and opening up of the floodgates of my heart has happened through automatic writing, showing me areas in my life to align with this legacy I want to leave here on earth, a legacy of love." End quote. From David, quote, "Automatic writing helps me enjoy the journey, adding a spice of excitement to my morning to start my day. It's awakened my heart. I don't think I know of any one of us who doesn't have a relationship where we don't necessarily hold something in a beautiful light. We can find peace and solace in automatic writing either by literally, quite literally, writing to those who've passed on and connecting to their essence, connecting to their soul, or connecting to that inner wisdom part of us that can speak for them." End quote. On a more practical level, Nicola Banker said, quote, "I was having a disagreement with my boss. So many knives in my back at work. I asked myself, what could I do about this? Automatic writing helped me in the most fantastical way." End quote. Through automatic writing, Nicole was able to see what was going on from other people's perspectives. Then she actually started getting confirmation from her bosses as to why these events were taking place. Automatic writing shared with her a roadmap of how she could either heal the relationship or become such a superwoman in the process that the experience and the knives in her back actually became positive fuel to make her a better human being. Loosely speaking, automatic writing has been the process used by authors and sages for thousands of years. Have you ever known someone who said, "A book just came to me"? Their fingers flew or they wrote or typed as if the universe was sending them a message and they were the vehicle to deliver the message. The universe will answer if you only ask. Many years ago, Jessica and I were nearly bankrupt. Meanwhile, I was making a comeback from a near-fatal accident, and she was ill with mold toxicity. Our lives were crumbling despite the fact that we were living in paradise on Maui. With so many challenges, we were completely overwhelmed. But once I put pen to paper with automatic writing, that all began to change. With one simple question, "What do I need to know today?" the puzzle pieces began to come together and our lives began to change quite dramatically. We learned how to start a show, the Inspire Nation show to be exact, now one of the top self-help and spirituality podcasts worldwide and wildly popular YouTube channel. We learned I had to get my life coaching going again, something I'd been doing for almost 20 years. I now coach and teach hundreds to thousands of people each week, one-on-one or through our Zoom meetings, our manifestation mastery circles, or our masterminds. And we learned each step of what we needed to do to help Jessica heal recover our finances, get back on track with life, and live a miraculous life wherever we are, whether we're in a dream home high above a Rocky Mountain town, nestled in the foothills with trails and animals all around, or traveling the U.S. in a massive RV and experiencing the magic and majesty of our national parks. As it was with Mary, David, and Nicole, and so many others whose lives have been touched and transformed by automatic writing, and you'll hear more of these stories shared by awe practitioners in the chapters ahead, so much of our success has come out of automatic writing. Quieting the monkey mind. Our minds are going a million miles an hour, telling us to turn right, turn left, go here, don't go there, or even telling us to freeze in our tracks. There's no winning with our minds, as the voices can be overwhelming, fear-based, and contradictory at best. Worse still, the voices in our heads aren't even ours. They're the voices of the collective, the tribe, our parents, the news, our egos, or who knows what. But they're not the voices of wisdom, and certainly not voices coming from our hearts. But when you go into automatic writing, you quiet the incessant chatter of the monkey mind, and you turn up your intuition. You're able to plug back into a knowing that's always been there, to a loving, kind, and gentle voice that can give you a big picture perspective of your life, where to go, where not to go, and the safest, easiest way to get there. With the automatic writing experience, I call it awe, confusion starts to melt away. You feel more at peace, more in alignment, and in greater accord with the world all around you. In essence, you find yourself in flow. What you hold in your hands in the awe-inspiring process is pure magic. A technique once available only to the prophets and sages, through the automatic writing experience, you have the ability to tap into the voice of the God you follow, the voice of the angels, or the voice of your highest guides, and you can get guidance on every aspect of your life. Want to know your path in life? Awe has answers. Want to know why you're still struggling? Awe knows that too. Want to know how to manifest, attract abundance, or attract the life of your dreams? It's in awe. Awe gives you direct access to a higher intelligence, a voice inside or outside of you that never lies, will never steer you wrong, and will help lead you to your greatest, most authentic, heart-centered, joyous life with far fewer struggles and less strife, if only you would listen. It's the voice that's always been inside of you, that small, still voice that will never steer you wrong. Just listen. The power is inside of each and every one of us. When you've heard, "Don't go down that dark alley," that's the voice of awe. And when you've yanked the steering wheel to the side away from danger, almost before knowing why, the voice that yelled, "Turn now," to avoid an oncoming truck, that's awe as well. It's like having your own internal GPS, the ability to tune in and get direction in a moment's notice. How awe works. Angels are my thing, so to me, that intuition is our guardian angels at work. But whether you call it angels, guides, higher self, God, or simply your inner wisdom, that voice is always there, always loving, and always waiting to give you a guiding hand. We only need to reach out and take it. So how does the automatic writing experience called awe work? In simplest terms, early on, you'll learn powerful but incredibly easy meditation techniques for even the most ardent non-meditator. You don't need to learn how to become a monk or sit in a cave to quiet the mind and stop the incessant chatter. For when we have a dozen competing stations playing in our mind, it's hard to hear anything, let alone a voice of wisdom. So this process will help you dial back those voices and learn to crank up your greatest inner voice. After learning basic meditations in this book, you'll learn some key simple prayers to step you down into a deeper trance-like state. From a neuroscience perspective, you'll be entering a theta brainwave state where your thinking mind goes quiet and your expansive spiritual mind opens. And from there, you'll learn a basic process or ritual that helps you step down even further into the wisdom and words that have always been there waiting for you. Of course, you'll learn advanced techniques as well, for guidance, for manifestation, even for talking with deceased loved ones and Mother Earth. There's no limit to where you can go with awe. Why do I call it awe? Because awe is the last thing you feel when you feel spun all alone and directionless, like a piece of wood floating out in a vast ocean. But when you can hear the voice of angels or the voice of God, your jaw drops, your heart expands, and you know, once and for all, you're not alone, never were alone, and never will be alone again. That sense of awe and wonder that fills your heart gives you greater courage, strength, and guidance to live life again and at a completely different level. In essence, awe is the state you get into through automatic writing when your pen is moving at a flurry and the words continue to flow. And they're not coming from you. You get direction, clarity, almost a postmortem on everything that's gone, quote, wrong. But most importantly, you get a higher level perspective on life and a vehicle where you can ask the divine or your inner wisdom any question you want. And you get reassurance that you're not alone, that you'll get through this, and that everything is all right, perfect in its own divine way, and can get even better. Unlike prayer, with awe you ask questions and actually get answers. If you simply turn the page, you'll learn how to access this inner wisdom in a matter of just days or weeks. And it's not magic, and not simply accessible to the few. Automatic writing doesn't require a special gift, a highly trained sense of intuition, or years in a cave honing your skills. It just takes a desire to plug in, to hear from the divine, and a little bit of practice to get the words flowing. But there's no one who can't plug in, no one who can't get steering from the divine. Why? Because each one of us has heard this voice or had a gut feeling or intuitive hit. We've each yanked the wheel at the last second to avoid an accident, or known who was calling before we even picked up the phone. It's this inner wisdom we're tapping into that's always been there just waiting for us to ask. What automatic writing is not. What if you go into automatic writing and say, I need 5 ideas to sell millions of books next year? That level of expectation, at least early on, crushes you in awe. What do I mean? Can't awe help with anything? Absolutely. But when you say, quote, I need, you've now gone to your head, to ego, and you're demanding that the bus driver tell the map maker where to go. It doesn't work that way. Instead, we get to go through this awe process and say, hey, I'm interested in having some bestsellers next year. What can you tell me? Where can you guide me? Is that reasonable? How do we get there? Rather than saying, or almost like putting a gun to awe's head, you will give me my bestsellers or $1 million right now. And awe will go, heek. Imagine what it'd be like to go into online dating and saying, you will sleep with me on the first date. And the connection is thinking, I don't even know your name yet. Of course, awe knows more about you than you do. But it's a process whereby you get to develop a relationship with awe. Until that relationship's developed, it's hard to get the deepest wisdom and just too easy to think you're in awe when you're really in your head. More about ego in a later chapter. We have to allow things to progress at whatever pace they are meant to. If we stick with awe as a daily practice, it's amazing how fast you'll start to get deeper wisdom. Automatic writing is not journaling. Journaling is a first-person writing experience. It's all about the first person, I, me, my. Whereas automatic writing is a second-person writing experience. It's about you. You are loved. You are good. You get to be more patient. And you are all right. Journaling is coming from the egoic thinking mind. We're just writing about what's taken place, what we're worried about, and analytical answers to our problems. As Einstein said, you can't solve a problem from the level of energy from which it was created. That's what journaling is. It's coming from your thinking mind. Contrast this with awe, which is coming from a higher wisdom, whether you call it inside or outside of yourself, below or above. But it's outside of your day-to-day thinking, and so it'll have higher level, far better answers. Don't get me wrong, journaling is a helpful practice. Journaling helps you get ideas out onto paper that you may not have thought of, and does help you to step back and look at your life and say, what's going on here? And it can be quite the cathartic process. But journaling doesn't help you step the aperture far enough back that you really separate it from the experience. When you dive into awe, you can step back from yourself. In spiritual terms, you become the infinite observer, or the one who cheers you on in life rather than participates in it. When you step back and get this infinite observer perspective, everything changes, especially the guidance you get. For you're no longer stuck in the trenches, but observing it from far above. It's a completely different process from journaling. Automatic writing comes from that inner wisdom, angels, guides, universe, source, or as I like to joke, the giant cheeseburger in the sky, whoever and whatever you want to call it. It's the voice on the inside that says, "It's okay, Michael. It's okay, dear one. It's all right for you to look at your world and the totality of it." Let me show you some things that you may not have noticed by being stuck in the role of the eye. Awe is not your crystal ball. While I write in awe daily, if not multiple times a day, and can hear that voice now loud and clear throughout the day, and especially when coaching, I do not rely on it to tell me what's going to happen in the future. First, it'll rarely tell me because the future hasn't been written, not by anyone. Okay, there's an infinite number of multiverses, and they are all taking place at once, but that's beyond the scope of this book. For our purposes, we live in a free will universe, so who knows what will happen? That's why when I coach or teach, I say my crystal ball is broken, for there are just too many elements going on to know what's coming when. Of course, all would say that take away the surprise, and where's the fun in that? Most importantly, when we try to predict the future, we often get out of that heart-centered, awesome place and right back into the head. We start thinking, conjecturing, and scheming about what the future may look like, and that's not awe. When I ask in awe what's coming next, I hear one thing consistently, time after time. You're not supposed to know the answers right now. In essence, this time of extreme uncertainty is here to help us grow, to help us dive into our spiritual nature, to help us let go of the outcome, and to help us heal the deepest, darkest wounds, which are coming out now more than ever. If we had the answers, then we wouldn't be able to expand, grow, or heal. In essence, when things are spoon-fed to us, why do we need to learn anything? Awe is also not great for big, life-changing decisions in the beginning. Over time, you can use awe for almost anything you can think of. But initially, with big, heavy, scary decisions, your egoic mind is likely to kick back in. For instance, if your concern is about finances, big moves, or even whether to stay married or not, great questions to ask in awe. Initially take the answers with a major grain of salt. Rather than looking at specific answers, look for themes or patterns over time. Automatic writing is not your Ouija board. While some might consider using the Ouija board as a form of automatic writing, this is not the method I am presenting in this book. So not to worry, I'm not taking you on an out-of-body experience or having your hand get taken over by a spirit. You'll retain control of your hand and your entire body for that matter. You are not getting possessed by another entity in any way, shape, or form. You are physically writing, not someone or something else. The messages are channeled through your mind first. Once your brain registers, it sends a signal to your hand to write out the message. If you're a natural born or practiced medium, you wouldn't need the writing part at all. But for most of us who are not born with the ability to channel or spend a great amount of time practicing this skill, the act of writing helps our brains tune into the messages. Automatic writing is not dictation. Again, while some might consider dictation a form of automatic writing, this is not what I'm teaching. I'm not teaching you how to channel a booming voice in your head. The only voice you're likely to hear in your head is your own. It's your own internal voice that is relaying the messages coming through. This section has looked at what awe is not. But here is a lovely spot to tell you, in the words of one of my students, what awe is, because I could not say this better than Miguel has. Quote, "A pencil, a rubber band, the chair on which you sit becomes a profound, unintended metaphor to explain life, consciousness, and the greatness of it all. This sense of awe is visceral as you wonder at the grace and beauty and magnitude of our interconnected universe. And you feel so whole and so complete and so with everything. There's nothing to need or want or to do except write another heart-stopping word. Beyond the mere cognitive, beyond the material, it erupts through you, a volcano from somewhere unseen. You are mesmerized with emotion, by life itself, by the infinite, by spirit." and the words just pour forward from your being with no need to delete. No wants, no regrets or edits. Isn't that a life in resonance with a spiritual master? Surely life is for these moments of awe." End quote. Three what-if questions about awe. 1. What if I can't write? I'm not a writer. I love it when people say they can't write or they hate to write. Why? Because they're often the first ones into awe and end up with the most profound words of wisdom, and it's so easy to tell it's not coming from them. So if you think you can't write, then perfect. It means your thinking mind won't be involved because you're not doing the writing. It's something I discussed with Andrew Newberg, MD. He's a neuroscientist who found that when people get into automatic writing, the part of the brain that normally writes, the frontal lobe responsible for your executive functions, including writing, powers down or reduces blood flow. So for those in awe, the part of the brain responsible for writing goes offline. Why is this important? Because if you've trained for years and years to build up your writing skills, you're in essence strengthening your frontal lobe, and now we need it to go offline. But if you've never strengthened it for writing, it's actually easier to power it down. And once you power down, then you open up to a whole new world. That's when consciousness, or your inner wisdom, or your angels come out to play. For when you get out of your writing mind, you more quickly get into awe. You don't have to write for a long time or think you'll fatigue or get writer's cramp, or that you'll be stuck writing for hour after hour, or having flashbacks of blue books and essays or exams. Remember those days? For you simply sit back, allow the pen to flow, and when it's done, it's done. Or you could even set a timer to make sure you finish in 10 or 20 minutes. This is not about efforting. It's about letting go at worst or playing at best. For there's nothing you need to write, no word count, no page count, nothing. In fact, if you just write gibberish for 10 minutes, that's fine too. Again, your aversion to writing and fear about writing will actually make your automatic writing more effective. The fact that writing is not your natural game, as Austin Powers said, "It's not my bag, baby," is going to help you to write even better than someone who skillfully crafts words with their mind, because their mind has an easier time of getting in the way. If writing truly is not your bag, more specifically, if you have some sort of condition, such as severe arthritis, that prevents you from actually holding a pen or typing, I've known people who dictate. You could call it automatic speaking, and the most amazing words flow through them. However, unless you truly have some sort of a condition, I would hold off and practice, practice, and practice first. Why? Because in automatic speaking, it's even easier to get tripped up by the thinking words of your mind. Therefore, if you're going to do automatic speaking, you'll want to record on your computer or recording device on your phone, or even an MP3 player to capture your words, and even better still, try speech-to-text software to help you convert the spoken word to text. 2. What if I'm afraid of letting negative spirits in? I call this one the Ouija board question. It seems in Ouija, you never know what spirit you're going to call in. But with the awe process, your intention prayer will serve a special purpose. In essence, your intention prayer, which I'll explain soon, is surrounding you in a protective bubble of love and light, and you're calling in only the highest energy or highest level spirits. In all of my experience, this has worked nearly 100% of the time. A word of caution. While I'm not concerned about you channeling uninvited spirits, as long as you follow the process I outline in the next few chapters, that is, use your prayers and write them down each and every time, there are rare situations in which someone may not be well suited for the awe process. I have a dear friend who once did pranayama breathing, which is alternate nostril breathing, and his bipolar tendencies threw him into a manic episode. So while I've never seen that happen with awe, I'm going to put in my fine print here. If you have manic tendencies or substantial bipolar challenges or are prone to schizophrenia or multiple personality disorders, I would not attempt awe. It'd be too difficult to determine who is saying what. Once any complex mental health issues are under control and your psychiatrist gives you the okay, that's a different story. But for now, I'd hold off. 3. What if I don't have time? This is a favorite question because I like to flip it on its head. There's a Zen koan that says, if you don't have time to meditate, meditate twice as long. To riff off that paradox, I'd say, if you don't have time to do awe twice as long. Why? Because awe will help you find more time in the day, find your blind spots, become more efficient, and quite literally give you more time. It's why even when I'm at my busiest or my clients are at their busiest, I have them do awe. For it sets them up for success for the day and it gives them time back. Now, certainly, if you have to take care of the kids or farm animals and you can't get up in time, then we need to look at how you can rearrange your schedule. But absolutely, you still get to do awe. No matter how challenging it seems in the beginning, you'll thank yourself for it. The process. In this book, I'll take you on a step-by-step approach, just as I do in my online training at automaticwriting.com and at my boot camps at inspirenationuniversity.com. Everything you need to know about the automatic writing process is in this book. I hope to simply answer your questions about the practices as we move ahead. I simply ask that you follow the technique as closely as you can before you make changes to it. Automatic writing is more than just a process of writing out ideas. It's a dynamic, time-tested, and systemic experience for gaining direct access to your higher self. When you have a process for accessing the wisdom of your highest self on a daily basis, you'll become what I call a bright and shiny beacon of light. You'll be able to use automatic writing to tap into your intuition and begin getting wisdom and guidance today. In the pages ahead, you'll learn the best environment for the practice, what to write before you begin, how to begin, and the best questions to ask for daily guidance and direction. You'll troubleshoot your daily challenges and receive answers that pertain specifically to what works best for you. You'll purge negativity and start healing your inner wounds. You'll get on the path of discovering who you truly are, why you're here, and what you're meant to do. Shall we begin? Chapter 2. Create the optimal environment for your automatic writing experience. Setting the stage for your automatic writing experience, awe, is as much a part of the process as the actual writing. Each year, I train thousands of people in automatic writing at automaticwriting.com. They want to know when they should tap into the universe for answers. Early morning, late night, they ask where awe should be practiced. Outdoors, in bed, a comfy chair, in yoga posture on the floor. And they want to know the initial steps to step down into that trance-like state of awe. Each person eventually evolves their own technique, but I like to start here, in this chapter, with the basics that answer the questions about where, when, and some beginning steps for you to create your own automatic writing experience. Awe is in the ritual. I like to say that everything in life is ritual or can be ritual. What does this mean? It means that we can live life consciously, as if everything were sacred and everything were ceremony. Not only does this enrich our lives, but it gives even more opportunity to connect with the divine, spirits, or our inner wisdom, whether driving down the road, at the office, working out, in prayer, or especially in awe. For everything is and can be made sacred. Now, what's the difference between ritual and ceremony? Ceremony is the activity. Ritual is how you get there. So your wedding is a ceremony, but the ritual is the act, like walking down the aisle, what's said, the ring slipped on the finger, the kiss. When I used to hold space in a meditation center, my practice was filled with a ritual. There was the lighting of the candles, the incense, and even the ringing of the bell. The importance of ritual is this. It primes you for a change in brainwave state. Ritual is an important method for getting yourself in a particular brainwave state or in the zone. In my discussion with neuroscientist Andrew Newberg, MD, we call it priming the brain. Baseball players do it by swinging the bat and may even go into prayer before they step up to bat. Tennis players bounce the ball several times before they toss it in the air before serving up an ace. Golfers do it with a practice swing. Guitar players do it by tuning their instrument. We all have ways we use ritual to shift our focus and take us from an ordinary mindset to one highly focused for the event ahead. With awe, the more we go into ritual, the easier it is for us to connect. From the minute you wake up, you're stepping outside of yourself and into awe. Silly as it sounds, from emptying the bladder, getting a drink, going into meditation, putting on the music, and going into your prayers, which I introduce in the next chapter, each event steps you further and further down the rabbit hole until voila, you're in a state of awe. That's one of the key reasons, even after all of these years, I don't skip a single step when going into awe. For I find the results far more profound when I go down the entire ladder rather than trying to skip the rungs. With that said, it's time to dive into the awe process, which we can now also refer to as the awe ritual, beginning with when to start your ritual. The importance of early mornings. I hear the groans from the I'm not a morning person readers.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.